Hi, this is Nicole Dyer, and this is the Research Like a Pro question and answer series. And today we're talking about how we can use AI for transcription of genealogical documents. And in this video, I give a brief tip about how you can use prompting in ChatGPT or Claude and a snip of or an image of a historical document like a deed to get a transcription. I also show some ideas for using FamilySearch Full-Text Search and their Summarize with AI feature to quickly understand what's inside of a deed, and then thinking about correcting the automatic FamilySearch Full-Text transcription using a large language model like ChatGPT and how that can help you remove repeated names or any kinds of anomalies. So I hope you enjoy this brief tip about using AI as you transcribe your documents and think about using them in your research reports or whatever you're creating. And now our final tip is about transcription during the research phase. And as you're research logging, you will need to do transcription for longer records. And you may be using the FamilySearch full text search. And here's an example of finding Robert Dyer in Hawkins County, Tennessee deeds as a witness. That's really one of the strengths of the full text search, is to be able to find individuals who are witnesses to deeds, who were witnesses to probate, because they're not going to be in the index because they weren't a grantor or a grantee or an executor or the deceased person who wrote the will. So this is a great way to find your person on additional records you hadn't found before. So this shows me that he was an associate to the grantor, Aquila Lane, which I hadn't known that this person was an associate of Robert Dyer before. So one of the things that FamilySearch Full-Text Search is now doing is this AI summary. So it generates this based on all the transcription of these two pages. So Aquila Lane, a resident of Jefferson County, Tennessee, made an indenture with William McKee for the sale of land in Hawkins County. The land was originally granted to Aquila Lane on October 3, 1809, and the deed was acknowledged and registered in court. And then it gives some information, the dates and the names and relationships. So we have the seller and the buyer. So that's kind of helpful. And then below it has the transcription. And sometimes the transcription isn't perfect. And I will take this, copy and paste it into ChatGPT or Claude and say, suggest corrections to this transcription. Now you can use multimodal LLMs, large language models, or AI tools like ChatGPT to help with transcription. And if you do, I suggest using a smaller part of the deed, and make sure you don't put the whole page that I showed before like this. You don't want to put this whole two pages in. It will get confused. So just take one page or one half of that one page and then put that in like that. And I like to use a prompt like this. You are an expert genealogist and transcriptionist. Transcribe this deed and put anything you can't read in square brackets with question marks or your best guess. And then here's the results that it gives you. And one thing I usually add is to do the transcription line by line and use the line breaks in the document so it's easier to check. And I would say this is like 80% correct. It struggles with names and dates, so you have to really check those. But a lot of the boilerplate language, it gets really good. And here's an example of when I pasted an automatic transcription from FamilySearch, and it had errors, and then I asked it to fix it up and give me the corrected text. So here's the corrected transcription with the names updated, and it gave me, it removed the repeated names, and then it gave me the list of corrections. So that was helpful. And finally, when you have a transcription and you want to convert it to a summary or an abstract for use in your report, or just to kind of get a condensed understanding of what the deed or will or probate record says, this is a really good use for a large language model. They're good at summarizing. If you provide a long transcription, then ask for a summary. It can help you quickly understand what's inside that transcription. And you can even use that in the body of the report and then put the full transcription as an attachment. This can help make the narrative part of the report more readable. And so here's an example prompt. You are an expert genealogist. Create an abstract of the newspaper article that focuses on important details like names, dates, and relationships. So hopefully this tip about the research logging and transcription phase can help you as you're working on finding important records and documents and using them in your research login report.